Hi, what's up YouTube? Today I'm going to talk about one of the best things I've done to this room. It's an extra room that I use as my office, and I basically just added one thing to it, which is this five-piece wall art that's canvas on wood frame. If you'd like to check out this exact set that's featured in this video, or other types of home decor for your bedroom, bathroom, or living room, then just check out the link I have in the description below. But I was really blown away at the quality of this thing when I received it. I had very high expectations, honestly, but I really didn't expect for it to be this nice. I thought it was going to be pixelated or, you know, it's not going to be as clear, but I'll try to zoom into the canvas so you can see the beauty of this thing. It just really, really pops out and it really transformed this room. But you can see how vibrant the colors are and how the horizon is just clear. I mean, it looks like you're actually sitting on the beach. And when you zoom into like the detail parts of like the rocks, like you can see the texture, it almost looks like you could touch it. I'm trying to zoom in here and show it to you, but hopefully the camera is able to capture all the detail. But I'll also come around at this angle here so you can see the sunset, and you can also look at the waves and look at the sand. And also, like I said, it wraps around the edges, so it gives it a really nice finish. But this is what it looks like from the left side angle there. For the rest of this video, I'm going to show you what you can expect whenever you order this item, and I'm going to give you some tips on how I hung up this wall art. So whenever you order your item, it comes in this nice little box, and I had five pieces. The largest piece was 10 by 24, then I had two other pieces that were 10 by 20, and then I had two smaller pieces that were 10 by 16 inches, for a total of five pieces. So whenever you get them, they're also wrapped in this little plastic. All you have to do is just peel it back and slide it out. It just comes out because it's in a little sleeve. And then the best thing to do is to go ahead and measure off your wall depending on where you want to put it. And my wall was about 130 inches, so I had to divide that by two and it comes out to be about 65 inches. Here's everything that I used to get this project done. I just use a nice little level, some nails, a hammer, a mechanical pencil, and a measuring tape. Here are the nails that I used to mount these pictures onto the wall. These are about 1¼ inches long, and here's what the box looks like. They're number 16. So the very first thing I did was mount my very first painting, the largest one, and that was 65 inches halfway into the room. Then 5 inches is half the width of each panel. And once you have the first one up, it's really easy to look at the rest of the pattern of the painting, and I use the horizon to make sure it's lined up. But basically, I would put it right against the wall, make sure I have a gap of an inch between each panel. But I'd like you to pay attention to that pencil mark. That is going to be the top of your canvas. You want to measure an inch down because that's going to be where you're going to nail into the wall. And so you can see the little hook cleat is exactly 1 inch away from that. So if you hang it up on the wall, it should match perfectly, as you can see right here. If you find your painting to be sitting kind of low, you can always give the nail a nice little tap with your hammer and it'll help match the pattern of your panel with the rest of your paintings. After you're all done, you should have something that looks like this. I hope you enjoyed this video. Be sure to like, comment, subscribe, and share the video. And as always, thank you all for watching.